I-25 near Montaño in Montgomery is scheduled to close right now as police continue to investigate a tragic and frightening accident from last night. We were the first on the scene of the crash that killed two, while another family in the crashed car is thankful to be alive. Action 7 reporter Lauren Zakalik is live with more.
Hey, Doug, APD is having quite a night. They say they're very busy, but they do tell us that they are still planning on shutting down I-25 near Montaño in both directions for about 20 to 30 minutes tonight, hopefully pretty soon. They're hoping to recreate what exactly happened right here last night. It was a devastating accident that had passengers thrown from a vehicle. One ended up flying from the southbound lane into the northbound lane. Now, this exact spot was closed last night, too, after police say a woman they suspect was drunk, lost control of a vehicle, and crashed into another one. Now, we were the first people to speak with the woman who was driving that other vehicle, who said she just couldn't avoid that crash.
There was nothing I could do except for just pray and scream.
The moments leading up to this deadly accident Tuesday night were torture for mother of two, Jennifer Westfall.
God was with us the whole time. The whole time.
Police say a car packed with five people in it lost control as it was exiting I-25 south onto Montgomery. The driver, police identify as 28-year-old Stephanie Mendez. They suspect Mendez, a convicted drunk driver, was drunk this time too.
There was dirt going everywhere, and I just knew that they were out of control, and I just slammed on my brakes, and they just came across the freeway, and we just hit them.
Westfall says she could do nothing to avoid smashing into them as their car drove back onto the highway. She and her two little children only had minor injuries. Passengers in Stephanie Mendez's car included 30-year-old Salvador Mendez. He was once charged with DWI, but the case was dismissed. He, Stephanie Mendez, and another passenger survived with minor injuries. The two other passengers died when they were ejected from the car. Now, police are trying to figure out what exactly happened, down to the smallest detail, so they can go forward with their investigation. Now, as you can see, traffic is still going right now. They have not closed down the highway yet. Now, police, in the meantime, are waiting on blood results of the driver's blood alcohol level. But they do say in their police report she didn't even remember why exactly she was driving last night. Reporting live, Lauren Zakalik, KOAT, Action 7 News.